Yeah, I mean, there's just one sentence, a dream has become true, because I was very skeptical how this whole thing would work for a computational chemist with computational PhD students, without computers, without infrastructure. And now seeing how this has developed is just breathtaking.
Supercomputer in my research career means everything. I started doing research and theoretical computational chemistry in an austere environment in terms of computational resources. There is no money, there is no one to help you with. So here at SMU, we have a lab called Supercomputer, and we have different people with different levels of expertise. They can always help you with the technical issues and also with the process of running the calculations.
The Center for Research Computing's goals over kind of time have been to just expand the use of high-performance computing resources across the campus, right, and what's available to researchers. And this started with the SMU HPC system, and then that paved the way for kind of demonstrating that I think that SMU had the chops to build its own clusters.
Having such a facility on campus is a huge advantage, especially if you think about there are not so many users. That means we can do things which we normally couldn't do.
The number of calculations that I run, for example, in a week, and I successfully get results for those calculations. Were it not for the supercomputer that we have here, what I do in 1 week would take me months in Brazil. So we're talking about powerful resource which is available to us here, and I don't think many people are aware of that. So the power, the value.
All kind of modern drugs passes through a computational chemistry workflow. You want to study how cells work and how proteins work inside of cells, you can model these things. Material design is another one, right? So if you're looking at how new materials can be designed for, you know, have special purposes, that can all be simulated through computational chemistry means. And so behind all of this, right, there is high performance computing that is the tool upon which all of these things run.
When I started here as a department chair in 2009, the department had 6 graduate students. Now we have 45 in 2 programs. So with the Moody School, this is now really something which helps us to get the word out. We are very serious about our graduate students, our PhD programs. What I really would like to see on the long run is that SMU becomes a hub for computational science.